हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ नरोडे गीताई। वेलकम टू माय चैनल स्टडी ऑफ लाइफ साइंस। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट HSK पाथवेज और C4 पाथवेज। द साइंटिस्ट हैच स्लैग वॉज डिस्कवर दिस पाथवेज, दैट्स व्हाई इट्स कॉल्ड एज अ HSK पाथवेज और दे ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज अ C4 पाथवेज। इट मीन्स द 4 कार्बन atom molecules is nothing but the oxaloacetic acid are stable product inside the cycle, that's why it's called as a C4 pathway. The C4 plant possesses a special type of leaf anatomy, it is called as a Krantz anatomy, in which the phloem which surround the bundle sheath cells, these bundle sheath cells consist of starch rich chloroplast and lack of grana. The bundle sheath cells is one of the ring of chloroplast which surround the mesophyll cells, and these mesophyll cells are different than the bundle sheath cell. Such type of chloroplast is called as a dimorphic chloroplast. So why plant need to adapt such type, the formation of Krantz anatomy? You know about the photorespiration. In that photorespiration, there is formation of glucose molecules by series of reactions. But the important thing is that this photorespiration is a waste of energy. It means whatever that formation of glucose molecules, which requires a lot of energy for the formation of single glucose molecules. In normal Kelvin cycle, if you know, there is formation of 12 PGA phosphoglyceric acid, this formation of one glucose molecules, okay. But in C2 pathways or photorespiration, there is formation of only 6 molecules, formation of one glucose molecules. So we can imagine that how the energy is required to formation of single glucose molecules. So we can say in simple word, the photorespiration is just waste of energy, is not get any out their energy. So what reason how this formation or run this pathways of C2 pathways? The behind reason that the temperature and CO2 concentration. If the CO2 concentration is high and temperature is low, in that condition, in Kelvin cycle, there is present the most important enzyme is nothing but the RuBisCO, ribulose bisphosphate carboxylase. This is the most important enzyme to fix CO2. If when the temperature is low and CO2 concentration is high, then they fix CO2. Otherwise, they fix O2. If the temperature is high and CO2 concentration is limitation, that time the RuBisCO has more affinity toward oxygen instead of CO2. That gets result the photorespiration or C2 cycles run, okay. And in that, these C4 pathways or HSK pathways, those plants, they also grow in drought condition or where the nitrogen and CO2 concentration is limited. So this plant may be run photorespiration or C2 cycle, and I told you that it is a waste of energy, so plant did never be worn. That's why this plant adapt itself to avoid this C2 pathways or photorespiration. So how this be avoided this pathways? In that pathways, you know, here is Kelvin cycles run, okay. So in that pathways, in C4 pathways, they increase the CO2 concentration around the RuBisCO enzyme. And I told you that if the temperature is high, okay, but the CO2 concentration is also high, that time they run the normal Kelvin cycle rather than photorespiration or C2 cycle. Okay, so that's why it be adapt itself. So let's see the cycles of C4 pathways. So let's discuss. So I told you that these pathways which run to chloroplast, mesophyll chloroplast and here bundle sheath cells, okay. So now let's start. The atmospheric CO2 which we enter, okay, and bind with water, there is formation of dicarboxylic acid by the presence of enzyme carbonic anhydrase, okay. And Okay, so there is first product, okay, dicarboxylic acid. That's why this pathway is also called as a dicarboxylic acid pathways. Okay, now once this dicarboxylic acid are formed, this dicarboxylic acid bind with phosphoenol pyruvic acid, which are three carbon compound. Okay, so we get oxaloacetic acid, which are a four carbon compound by the presence of enzyme phosphoenol pyruvate carboxylase. This oxaloacetic acid is the formation of aspartic acid or malic acid. It depends on which enzyme present in chloroplast. If the enzyme transaminase are present, then the oxaloacetic acid, which are four carbon compound, converted into the aspartic acid. Okay, and these are a reversible process. In contrast, if the enzyme malic dehydrogenase are present, so in that condition, the oxaloacetic acid are converted into the malic acid by using the energy carrier. Okay, so this reducing agent NADPH plus H plus are reduced and is formation of NADP. Okay, and we get malic acid and also aspartic acid. Okay, so it depends on the enzyme present in chloroplast. When this malic acid and aspartic acid are formed, they transport the mesophyll cells or mesophyll chloroplast to bundle sheet cells through plasmodesmata. Okay, this is the plasmodesmata. Now, this bundle sheet cell, the malic acids are rich. This malic acid undergoes oxidative dehydrogenase. Okay, that get result, there is release a CO2 and energy carrier, which NADPH and H plus, and there is a formation of pyruvic acid, which are three carbon compound. You know, malic acid are four carbon compound. Okay, so in that four carbon, one which CO2 are released, and remaining three carbon which forms a pyruvic acid. So now here is CO2 is released at this energy carrier or reducing agent is also released, and this CO2 and energy carrier which enters the Kelvin cycle and the formation of carbohydrates. I already made video on Kelvin cycle, so you can watch this video for better understand each and every process how run the Kelvin cycle. Okay, so I told you that here is one important enzyme Rubisco. Okay, ribulose bisphosphate carboxylase, it is a very important enzyme to fix CO2. Okay, and in that bundle sheet cell, the CO2 concentration around the Rubisco enzyme become increases, get result which run the normal Kelvin cycle instead of C2 cycle. Okay, it is very important. Okay, remaining is just to be converted. So the malic acid which forms a pyruvic acid, they requires enzyme malic enzyme. The pyruvic acid which again transfer the mesophyll cells through plasmodesmata. The pyruvic acid which converted into the phosphoenol pyruvic acid, which are three carbon compound by the presence of enzyme phosphate pyruvate dikinase enzyme. When this phosphoenol pyruvic acid are formed, this pyruvic acid again bind with dicarboxylic acid, then formation of oxaloacetic acid, which is the first stable compound in this C4 pathways. Okay, that's why the cycles again run. So this all about the C4 pathways or HSK pathways. So if you like these videos, please like, share with your friends, and definitely subscribe my channel. Thank you.